Chapter 1 Topic Fund Based Accounting. So first of all, we will learn what is the meaning of fund. Fund means the amount received or set aside by not-for-profit organizations for a specific purpose. Since it has received for a specific purpose, it can't be used for other purposes. So what is fund based accounting? It means the accounting whereby receipts of donations and incomes relating to a particular fund are added, or you can say credited, and payment and expenses are subtracted to it. For example, there are a lot of funds like building funds, sports funds, prize funds, library funds, etc. So what is the treatment in final accounts of not-for-profit organizations? Like if there is credit balance in the fund, then it is shown in the liability side of balance sheet. But if there is debit balance, then it is debited to income and expenditure account. Let us take an example to understand the concept and treatment of fund-based accounting. So we will do two questions here. If there is credit balance, given information is balance of sport fund on 1st April is 5 lakh, 10% sports fund investment on 1st April is 5 lakh, interest received on sports fund investment is 37,500, donations for sports fund is 1,20,000, sports prizes awarded 1 lakh, and expenses on sports event is 15,000. So what is the treatment of these information in the balance sheet? First of all, we will calculate the interest we have received. There is the amount of investment is 5 lakh and we have received only 37,500 interest. So we will calculate the 10% of 5 lakh is 50,000. Since according to accrual basis of accounting, we will record 50,000 interest, but we have received only 37,500 interest. So the difference, like 12,500, is accrued interest which must be added. So what is the treatment in balance sheet? Here the sports fund amount is 5 lakh. We will record the interest which we have received, 37,500, and the interest accrued which we have calculated, 12,500. Also, we add donations in fund-based accounting. We add donations like 1,20,000 here we added. Expenses we debited or subtracted. So, sports prize awarded is 1 lakh and expenses on sports event is 15,000. So, now the balance is 5,55,000. Here, sports fund investment is also an asset. We will show it on the asset side of balance sheet. Interest accrued is also an asset, like 12,500 also will be shown in the asset side. We can also show it in the working note. The total interest due is 50,000. Interest received is 37,500. So interest accrued is 12,500. It will be added to sports fund as we have added already. Plus, it will be shown in the asset side of balance sheet. So, this is an example of if there is credit balance. If there is debit balance or negative balance, then we will show the following information in financial statements. Here, the details are match expenses, 8,80,000, match fund, 2 lakh, donations, 2,40,000. And sale of match tickets is 3,60,000. So now the treatment in balance sheet and income and expenditure account is, first of all, given information, match fund is 2 lakh, donations is 2,40,000. Then we will add sale of match tickets, because in fund based of accounting we add all the receipts. So we will add donations as well as sale of match tickets. Our balance is now 8 lakh. But the match expenses are given 8,80,000. We cannot deduct 8,80,000 from 8 lakh. So we will deduct only 8 lakh, which is our balance, and the difference amount is nil, which will be shown in the liability side of balance sheet. Now, since the expenses are more than the receipts and the difference is 80,000, so 80,000 will be shown in the debit side of income and expenditure account. So here the concept is clear. If there is credit balance, then it will be shown in the liability side of balance sheet. But if there is debit balance, then only nil amount will be shown in the balance sheet and the balance will be shown in the debit side of income and expenditure account. I hope you will understand all the concept. Now your homework is to do questions relating to fund-based accounting in your notebook.